different topic.
Yeah. So, how many of you are sure when the capsular excess runs away? When it runs away, the maneuver which is followed is basically, in this video as you will see, the capsular excess is being done in the routine way. The capsular excess flap is being formed, and suddenly you realize that it has extended to the periphery. I cannot stop it because there are some issues. Now, what do we do now? We deepen the AC. After deepening the AC, the next thing which needs to be done is we need to make the flap within our control. And how do we do it? We make it slightly concave. Then we go as close as possible to the end of the flap and pull it in the direction in such a way that the vector forces, resultant vector forces, make it go that way. I cannot show it with the arrow. I would have been able to, but it is not coming. So this Little's maneuver is possible at certain conditions. But what should we do when it doesn't come back? Well, when it doesn't come back, we have an Argentinian flag sign. So my question, I see new faces, in the sense those who have not been in North. How many of us have not heard of flap motility sign? Can I know? Or each one of you have heard? Oh, so that's a good number. So that will serve my day. So now what happens is, when it goes away, what do? We are always in a surgical dilemma. What to do? So the next thing is, we should know what flap motility sign is. This flap motility is a sign of posterior capsule rupture in peripherally extended anterior capsular tears. If the flap, for that matter, these are the different types of anterior capsular tears, the pre-equatorial tear and the post-equatorial tear. Now the next is, what is happening there now? Is it okay now?
Yeah.
Yeah. We have complications when it extends to the periphery. We have to convert to manual extraction in 5% of cases, and we have seen that there is a nucleus drop in a good percentage of patients. There's always a surgical dilemma whether to convert or to, you know, continue with phaco, and we are already aware of the classical signs of, you know, these posterior capsule rupture. The problem with these classical signs of posterior capsule rupture are they do not appear instantly. And there is always a time lag for recognition of the signs, which varies according to the expertise of the surgeon. So here you will see that the flap is fluttering. So when this flap is fluttering, what does this mean? This means that it is pre-equatorial. And if it extends beyond the equator, then it would not flutter. Just see this animation, and in this animation you will see that the flap is fluttering and it is averted. A fluttering flap is indicative that it is pre-equatorial by all means. I hope for those who are new to it, they should, you know, what is required is that they should just look at the flap. So why does this happen? It simply happens because of the fact that the end of the flap, I have to see there whether it is, yeah, end of the flap, you know, there's a short arm. It becomes responsive to the fluidics in the anterior chamber. When it becomes responsive to the fluidics, it flutters. Had it gone beyond, it would not have fluttered. So that acts, that end point acts as a pivot around which it rotates or around which it flutters. Now, what I would like you to do is, I would like you to see this video. In this video,
Yes.
Is the video working now?
Working.
Working, it was working?
Yes.
Sorry. I don't think it is. It is. Yeah, it is working. Yeah. Yeah, this is the Argentinian flag, which is already there. Now I want you to focus on that flap. You would find that this stripe and blue flap is fluttering. So when it is fluttering, you continue with your safe phacoemulsification techniques, and you should conclusively go ahead with your phacoemulsification. Is it a new development? Well, definitely it is not a new development. Our focus has always been, you know, our focus has always been here. It has never been here. So we just need to widen our field of vision, continue with the phacoemulsification, and you can see here during the cortical aspiration, it is still fluttering. So this fluttering should make you be convinced about the fact that it is pre-equatorial. And you can very well put an intraocular lens, because if the flap, with flap motility sign not in your armamentarium, you would not have known, you would have been in a quandary whether to put it in the bag or you should do some other maneuver. But if the flap is fluttering and it had fluttered, you can very well put the IUL in the bag. Now, what is the hypothesis with a non-fluttering flap? Usually what happens is there is a barrier between the high fluidic pressure in the anterior segment and a low pressure compartment in the posterior segment. Now what happens is whenever there is a breach in that barrier, this is high pressure, this is low pressure, there is a breach, this negative pressure pulls it down. So when it pulls it down, the nucleus also drops. And when it gets pulled down, the flap also gets pulled down. And when the flap gets pulled down, it doesn't flutter. So this is what the hypothesis is. Yeah, here, you know, when it becomes post-equatorial, it stops fluttering and it becomes inverted. Again, it is being repeated. It becomes flat and it becomes non-fluttering. Now, this, when it extends beyond the equator, there's a breach, as I already told you. There's a negative pressure here. There's a high pressure here. And with a big volume here, big volume and anterior capsular tear gets pulled down. So that is conclusive of the fact that it has extended beyond the equator. And that is usually the end point of safe phacoemulsification. So these classical signs of posterior capsule rupture, they appear later on. So this appears the moment you find that it has stopped fluttering. Well, that should be the end point of safe phacoemulsification, and you better convert. Dr. Stanshu, it's beyond me. I'm sorry. It's beyond my control. So this is the end point. I'm just trying to show the end point of safe phacoemulsification. This is the end point. Now it has extended. Now I would like you to see a video. In this video, the resident is trying to extend to create a larger excess. In a process, what he does is this capsular excess extends to the periphery. You can see the flap. It is fluttering out here. He is doing his routine procedures. As the procedures which he is doing are continuing, the next step which he does is he tries to divide. Just see here. Suddenly what will happen? It has stopped fluttering. He should have stopped with phacoemulsification, inflated the bag, and done with the converting maneuvers. He, oblivious of the flap motility sign, he continued with phacoemulsification, and you can see the end point that it goes behind. So this is what the flap motility sign is. So you see that it continues. He continues, and we end up with a situation that it goes into the posterior segment. So with this flap motility sign in your armamentarium, it makes you feel what the end point of safe phacoemulsification is. It eliminates the dilemma in the presence of anterior capsular tear. It reveals the extent of the anterior capsular tear. Confidence, well, it brings in confidence for surgeons of all expertise. It prevents catastrophes, and conclusive for IUL implantation in the bag. Small things at times make a large difference. Thank you very much for your